Good morning, and thank you for joining another hour at the Golden Hour. I am here live Monday through Friday, 9:45 to 10:45 a.m. Central Standard Time in the United States, if you want to catch me live. This channel is called the Golden Hour because I want it to be a chance to do whatever you want for an hour with companionship, and that's what I'm here for. And that's what I'm providing, and it's also what I'm getting. I get to focus on something I want for an hour and have you all here with me. So I want to let you know that, and then to let you know, certainly you can like, you can subscribe, but I would love it if you would comment if you're watching this live or on the replay, because I'd love to know who you are and what you're about and get to interact with you. If you are wanting to study for longer than an hour, just feel free to watch my other videos. I start each session, each stream, with a recommendation. So that's usually a nice time to take a break and kind of relax. You can listen to the recommendation if you want. You can take your break, and then we get started on about 50 minutes of studying, working, whatever you want. So, pardon me, I'm a smidge late today, but we are here and we can get started. So before I click over to it, my recommendation for today is going to be a children's book. I have children, and one of the many things I discovered being a parent is how wonderful I find children's literature. I'm going to paraphrase a C.S. Lewis quote that goes something like, if a children's book only appeals to children, it's not good in the slightest. Something like that. But of course, the best children's literature appeals to both children and adults. Sometimes I find books just simply beautiful because of their artwork. Other times it's more their message that appeals to me, etc. So this is a book I was introduced to at a friend's baby shower many years ago, and I thought the book was fantastic, and I have bought it for us, and I've bought it for other friends. So I'm going to go over to the Amazon page with the book on it, but unfortunately it doesn't have the look inside feature, so I will show you some pages as best I can from my own book. Okay, so the book I'm talking about is called People by Peter Spier. And I think the back cover image looks pretty much the same. So it just shows you, you know, it's a crowd of people, right? And what the book does is it talks all about people all over the world. And it addresses some of the broad topics of being human. And I loved that it did that for children. And I loved that it did it globally. And it really appealed to me to, from my children's younger years, orient them globally to certain conversations. You know, that talks about people playing games all over the world. This is what it's like. People dress differently all over the world. People eat different things all over the world. What's acceptable in some countries is not acceptable in other countries, etc. And I thought that was just such a great foundational framework from which to view the world for a child. So let me switch back here to my main camera and try to show some of the book inside. So there's the world, of course. Let's flip through a few pages. I've never looked at that opening quote before. In many ways, the saying, know thyself, is not well said. It were more practical to say, know other people. And that says Menander, 343 to 292, Greek poet. And I love when any I love when any children's literature doesn't sort of reserve certain things for adults. I love the idea of introducing children to great authors, thinkers, poets, etc., from a young age, musicians, etc. So let's look a bit at this. I bet you didn't think you were going to get read to from a children's book today, did you? We all know that there are lots and lots of people in the world, and many more millions each year. There are now over 6 billion human beings on Earth, and if it takes you an hour to finish looking at this book, there will be over 4,000 more. By the year 2050, there will be 9 billion people on Earth. If we all joined hands, the line would be 5,708,806 miles long, and it would stretch 229 times around the equator, or 24 times the distance to the moon. More than 6 billion people, and no two of them alike. Each and every one of us different from all the others, each one a unique individual in his or her own right. We come in all sizes and shapes, tall, short, and in between. But without a single exception, we all began quite small. And we come in many colors. Even our eyes have different shapes and colors. And noses come in every shape imaginable. So do faces, lips, and ears, and everything else. Think of our hair, from snow white to pitch black, straight, curly, kinky, and wavy. And a lot of people have no hair at all. People are funny. Some with straight hair want theirs to be wavy, and others with little curls want theirs straight. People around our world wear different clothes, or none at all. All of us want to look our best. Still, what is considered beautiful or handsome in one place is considered ugly and even ridiculous elsewhere. I just love it. I mean, I'm gonna have to try to get myself to stop. Some of us are wise, some of us are foolish, but most of us are somewhere in between. Most people are decent, honest, friendly, and well-meaning, but some are none of these. Some of us love noise, whereas others simply cannot stand it. And not everybody's idea of a good time is alike. So then it'll go on to share all sorts of like games from around the world. Love it. Homes being different. People being good at different things, and what makes some people laugh makes other people cry. Many of us like doing things with others, some of us like being by ourselves. That's funny. I was just thinking some today too about how this setup is perfect for what my friend calls together alone time. So for introverts, it's great. It's the best combination. You're alone and you're like studying or reading and getting something done, but hey, you're also kind of together. Keep all sorts of pets, celebrate different holidays, things we like to eat are not the same. Some people wouldn't touch what other people's, consider a delicacy. And this says we practice nine main religions, and there are thousands of others as well. Many people believe in one God, and millions of others believe in many gods, and many millions more do not believe in anything at all. I love that. It doesn't pull any punches. It doesn't pull a punch it just because you're a kid. It lets you know straight off the bat, here's what you're going to encounter in the world. Oh, you're going to encounter a lot of people that believe in one God. You're going to encounter a lot of people that believe in many gods. And there are plenty of people that don't believe in anything at all. I love how straightforward that is. I love that. Okay, so, and then it talks about people being rich, people being poor. Most people have to work. There are lots of ways to do that. Almost everybody can speak. There are 200 different 201 different languages. I'm talking about deaf people communicating a different way. Look at this, showing all the languages. I love it. So it turns out I'm not going to stop. It turns out I'm going to go through the whole book. Some people, but very few, are mighty and powerful, although most of us are not mighty at all. We have invented a strange system of ranks, grades, and classes. Yet we all live on the same planet, breathe the same air, and warm ourselves in the same sun. And in the end, we all must die. A children's book. I still love, though, that it points out, like, wow, you're going to see people with all sorts of different life experiences, but we all live and all die. A few of us are remembered long after we're gone, and even that in countless different ways. 6 billion human beings, young and old, sick and well, happy and unhappy, kind and unkind, strong and weak, people everywhere and all different. It is very strange. Some people even hate others because they are unlike themselves, because they are different. They forget that they too would seem different if they could only see themselves through other people's eyes. But imagine how dreadfully dull this world of ours would be if everybody looked, thought, ate, dressed, and acted the same. Now, isn't it wonderful that each and every one of us is unlike any other? And I also just love the subtle messaging of the sort of front page and end pages. Here we are, we're talking about our world and how different it can be. And just a reminder, we're just something floating in space. Just one of many planets. So, I love this book. I think it's fantastic. I don't have the cover on mine. Book jackets don't always last too long in my house. I find it too hard to read with the jacket on them. So that is my recommendation for today. I hope you enjoyed hearing about it. It's a great book. I'm going to reset the timers here and we will get started. Hello, if you're just joining us, feel free to. Sometimes I look up and actually see when someone joins. Yeah, so if you're just joining, feel free to type where you are and what you're studying. Sorry, my planning will involve a lot of page ripping noises. Don't know about you all, but I am a very written person. If I want something, if I want to remember something, I need to write it down. And then sometimes I just have too many like lists and notes going, so I gotta consolidate. That's what we're doing now. Excuse me. Allergies. Okay, I see our time has come to an end. I am pleased with the amount of planning I got done. I mean, mostly it's like just sorting through things and being like, I don't need all these old notes and lists. So that was good. That helps my mind feel more settled. Yeah, so I hope you enjoy the rest of your day or evening whenever you're watching this, and I hope to catch you again tomorrow. All right, bye-bye.